Hello, welcome to today's video. This video will be slightly different from the previous video. If you did not see the previous video, you can watch it through the link in the description. I hope you like this video. Please follow, like, and share to spread the benefits. I have prepared 20 mm of hydrogel. You can watch the mixing process using the magnetic stirrer. The parameters shown in the video are the duration, temperature, and mixing speed required for the mixing at each stage. After we finish mixing the hydrogel, you can notice the formation of air bubbles and foam on the surface of the mixture. We will get rid of them later. We will prepare a mixture of iron flakes and hydrogel that we have prepared in advance to be used as a material for scaffold printing. We added iron flakes to make up 1% of the total weight in addition to changing the mixing method from magnetic to mechanical due to iron's magnetic properties. We need at least 20 minutes of mixing to ensure that the iron fillings are spread almost evenly in the hydrogel. We will pour the mixture vertically immediately after the completion of the mixing process. Always remember not to allow hydrogel to cool before this process. In today's video, we will use the KR2 for printing. This cartridge is characterized by its ability to handle a pressure of 1000 Pascal without any problems. In addition, the thermal printing up to 180 Celsius. You can learn more by visiting the Hyrule website in the description below. Roll the hydrogel to rest for at least 30 minutes to allow air bubbles to rise freely to the surface. Always remember not to suppress freedoms. You can use hydrogel again, as it's preferable to store it at a low temperature to preserve it. I personally prefer to use 10 mm of hydrogel per print, as you can control it easier and reduce waste as much as possible. We will close the cartridge now, using a special tip to press the mixture. We will seal it tightly using the black cap. After making sure it tightly closed, we will slowly squeeze the mixture out to allow the foam and air bubbles to escape. There is no real measure of this process as the amount of bubbles varies each time, but pushing it out or at least making sure it collects on the surface is very important for a smooth printing process. We will store the cartridge at 4 Celsius for 10 minutes to reach the desired viscosity. This duration depends on the content of the mixture and its additives. Always remember to place the cartridge vertically to ensure there are only air bubbles, foam, or any unwanted components on the surface. We don't want any spaces inside the cartridge before the cooling process. After the time has passed, we will now load the cartridge to the printer to make sure of the consistency of the mixture. You can push it out and check it. We will remove the black cap to load the cartridge into the printhead. Always remember to close the black cap after loading the cartridge. I will be making another video later for another scaffold options available from Hyrule. Until then, you can follow Hyrule's YouTube channel to see the latest developments in the company. Always make sure you have the latest version of WebPetrol and the latest version of your printheads and printer's firmware. In addition, I'm currently working on another video to get rid of air bubbles and foam using heat. Follow the page to see what's new. I hope you enjoyed this video, and remember always to keep it 3D. See you in the next video.